Oh, I see. That's what. That's the point. Yes, yes.
Tattoo. I'll take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise. Might even grow me a Fu Manchu. Tattoo. I'll take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise. Might even grow me a Fu Manchu. And it's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's a
Three hours of the morning.
It's black.
Okay.
Well, we're on our way. 6:46. Larry's had two coffees, taking care of business, got gas, and he's talked to Ray Lee. So everything's done.
Ready to go.
Ready to go. And we are on our way to the bridge.
It's 7:29, and here we are. Reaching the bridge.
That's where we are.
Perfect, thanks.
Thank you.
I thought we were going to get some change.
$5, four axles.
Maybe some.
From everywhere. It's a little embarrassing.
Flop, flop, choo, choo. Oh, what a relief it is.
It's 9:29 and we're sitting, waiting, patiently to go.
Right.
Both. Between what? Sydney and Marquette.
Right.
Or Munising.
Munising. Patiently, we should emphasize.
With a total of 6 minutes out of our trip, we're going to charge that to the state of Michigan.
Jennifer Granholm.
Whatever the county is here or something. What a beautiful day. 65 degrees, and we're on our way. And the nuts eating nuts.
Thank you, thank you.
And Larry has decided that since the tank is empty, we're going to fill up at 244. See how he maneuvers this thing. So we did our fill up. Only took $48.50. So that was good. Leaving Munising at 10:04 a.m. And we're on our way. And we both decided that we're going to have to put more in the pot, because our first fill-up just about took it all. It's a trip of road improvement.
In Michigan.
Yeah, only in Michigan. It'll go away when we hit the border. After hours of boring, tedious driving, the man still is carrying on. And we are right there. Just went through Berglund. Yeah. We're in Wakefield. We just filled up for gas.
Wakefield. $10 worth of gas?
Yeah, $10 and $28 added to that. He's been resting for about, I don't know, 4 hours or something.
Oh, five or six. Just sitting here doing nothing.
And I'm just speeding away here, getting us through the Minneapolis area. It's 9:37 Michigan time, 8:37 here.
Living high. Living high.
We're living high. We're not on the second floor.
We're living high.
But we're living high. 239, 240, right there. Where are we? Fremont.
This is Fremont.
Fremont, South Dakota. And
we're living high.
And we're one of the beggar groups that came in here. We're going to eat at the ranch. Just to keep you apprised of our progress at this point, the ranch is ahead of us.
On over to this fine restaurant. We understand it's a 5-star.
Yes, we're at the ranch. Yes, we're trying to find the entrance now. Dinner's within our reach, we know that.
Please wait to be seated.
Bar 695.
That'd be something simple. Just riding in the car all day and eating constantly with Larry.
Yeah, this is constant companionship here.
He needs a shave, but maybe I'll erase that out of the picture when I do
Dinner's
this.
Dinner's over.
Time to go to bed.
The night's just begun to go to sleep. It's 4:25 this time, but it's 2:25. No, 6:25 at home, right?
That's right.
We're on our way.
We're moving.
Before we leave this little burg, McDonald's wasn't open. It's only 4:30 local time, so they weren't open. So we went to the guy next door and got coffee.
And on their gas station pumps, they have fresh coffee.
Do they really?
See that? Right there.
Oh, you mean it says it. 5:38 local time. And we're starting to see a lot of activity. Not that we didn't before, but as you can see, there must be something going on out here west. We've crossed the border into South Dakota here, and we need gas again. Getting gas.
Don't worry, be happy.
You wouldn't be able to interrupt that. I hear you. Weather here is, I mean, a cloud in the sky, 64 degrees, just awesome. So, what's your temperature there?
Has this made our reservations for the night without any problem? We'd like everybody listening to this to know that.
Good to go.
We're at Keystone at the Holiday Inn, and it was significantly easy for a talented person. I'd have still been on the side of the road wondering what to do, but...
Well, we're at mile marker 181, about where my finger is. And we're going to end up there south of Rapid City in Keystone tonight.
It's just a constant stream of trailers, bikes, more bikes. Never been on this road when they've had so much traffic. Just keeps going and going.
Made it. We're in Keystone at the Holiday Inn Express. 1 o'clock, local time.
Guys, don't park in the street. The employees are sick. Pulling.
There's our man, and we just unloaded the bikes. And it's pretty warm, but we're getting ready to go. We're in Keystone going to Mount Rushmore.
Well, here we are at Mount Rushmore.
Confusion with the camera, perhaps.
Thank you.
because we don't suppose you like
weather. Oh, well. How you doing?
Yeah. Yeah, I didn't go to Michigan.
I didn't either.
No, but you married one.
Oh, I see. That's the point. Yes, yeah, I see. That's the point. Yes, yeah, I see. That's the point. Yes, yeah, that's the point. Yes, yeah.
There's my old friend from the previous trip. He knows it's very warm.
Hides under a rock.
And hides under a rock. There's a lot like some guys I know.
Groundskeepers at a lot of places, so just keep walking this way and
take this
path. Oh, I'm just snapshotting. Okay. Yeah, right now is what. All right, we're getting a little water for a trip.
Two waters.
Well, we've ridden down the Crazy Horse. And there's our bikes. And there's what she looks like today up there.
Keystone. We're meeting at 6 o'clock in the lobby. It's 1:45. After a great ride this afternoon, there's my man down there.
Well, we're walking down to Keystone to take a look at the bikes. We don't have to walk down there, we can look anywhere. It didn't look like this last time I was here. It didn't look like this.
Too bad, man. I guess you gotta be checking.
She doesn't need to, she's already got her.
somewhere.
We've got this entertainment Mary made me come to. Not for you, it's for the camera. Yeah, I see why you made me come here.
A little shower.
Are you done with the music?
Oh, wait a minute. Look in there real quick. I don't know if it's still there. After beer and wine, sort of quieted down, so this is it for this first day.
Well, I might go get me a new tattoo, or take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise, might even grow me a Fu Manchu.
Okay, it's 6:34, and the preparations for Sunday, August the, must be the 6th, 5th? Anyway, we're starting out.
There's the game lodge.
Yeah, the man has just figured the morning out.
The commentator begins to speak. We must say, for you people watching at home, don't try this at home. This is for professionals only. That was easy for me to say. Now, where are we?
We are in Custer County in the Black Hills, and we are now motoring toward the National Park, Custer National Park.
Yes, indeed.
We're moving.
We thought we'd take a look at what this particular outlook is.
This tourist biker here, he's getting a picture. And we can see Mount Rushmore.
7:56.
Well, 7. He set my watch.
No.
It's 7. North Dakota, that's where you change.
South
Dakota.
Okay,
thank you. I'm going to go to Yellowstone.
Okay, I'll hold that.
Don't try this at home.
Yes, sir. Get down there.
Well, we'll incorporate that picture right in this video when he gives it to me. Did you take one?
Hell yes.
All right.
Now stop. Now put that damn thing down. We're there.
We're going to take you up where he is and show you what kind of picture he's taking. In the distance is Mount Rushmore. And those darn motorcycles and their noise down there.
Isn't that Chief Crazy Horse? Ooh, baby. It's smart if you went off there. It's smart.
Lawrence Campbell is over there now, providing the public with information. Accurate and
that
true.
We get dinner.
Hunting dinner.
Yeah, hunting. Where'd he go? Let's see what that picture is, so we. They are majestic. Well, just up the road, we had to come and take another look. Let's walk over there, okay?
Yeah, let's get that big pole that's right there to the right.
Here we go, right there to the right. Where is, sort of the third one in there?
Yeah, that's
I think I got him.
Calf, and then it looks like the bull.
Kind of small shoulders on that guy. Wow. Yeah, he's all by himself now. Look at that guy. We're not the only ones. Okay, we're going on into the Custer State Park.
few more.
Yeah, they got a few. They got a and the bulls are big suckers.
Man, they are. They get the show. Ben, you heard it right here.
But we're recording that we're looking. Hello. Pardon the ring.
I got the wrong number. Here.
We didn't get through. We got the wrong house this time. So we're trying again. Gong, are you home?
This will make the video interesting to you. Being part of our trip. Being buffaloed here. I'm like one of those newscasters. I have to say something and we're sitting
there. You gotta fill it.
Yeah. Not going through?
Well, it's going through, but nobody's answering. About 8 rings.
Really?
They must be all out goofing off, having breakfast.
Don't they know that we were going to call? Evidently not.
I think that's it.
Well, I'll tell you what, if we're going to hang up.
We've recorded our effort.
And we wanted them to be part of this experience, so we'll try later maybe.
Talk to you later.
Well, we spotted several antelope and weren't able to stop, but this time we got a few over there. And I guess they really don't care about us. Now this one's fairly exciting. We're amongst them. They're on both sides of us. One stop after another. There were some donkeys over there, mules. We presume they're wild, like us. These antelope are 25 feet from us and they don't really care. So we got a little picture here. Show you the surrounding areas. There's a few antelope over further away. The ones behind us that I just showed you kind of are getting a little skittish.
Look at those tiny little fawn or whatever they are. They're skittish.
Well, I might go get me a new tattoo. Or take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise. Might even grow me a Fu Manchu.
All right, we're just making a little stop here. Something different. Yeah. It's the old looking across the valley trick again.
Must have had a fire here, bud.
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. A long time ago, too.
Just thought that the producer and the director ought to get in the movie. God, it's awful here, but
somebody's got to do it.
Yeah.
Those state parks love those bikers.
Oh yeah. As you can see, never-ending stream. We've been riding on Needles Highway in the park here. It's not in the park. Yeah, it is in the park.
Yeah.
We've been riding on Needles Highway or whatever. We're going to try and make another call back to Commerce. And my technical manager is trying to handle that.
Ringing.
Good.
You're missing some pretty good stuff going by, too.
Oh.
That should be cut.
Yeah. No. Well, you know, it's good-looking bikes.
Good-looking bikes.
Nothing, huh?
They must have gone to the Detroit Zoo for a day out.
No telling.
All right, it appears that this may be a boring part of the film.
We have made, we're now recorded though, that we have made major efforts to make contact.
And have them part of this trip.
Exactly, so it's not our fault.
All right.
Not even a little bit. You know?
Cutting out. I'm done. Deadwood.
Well, we've got the bikes loaded and we're on our way to Deadwood, and it's the car says it's 93. We don't know if it's reached the right temperature yet, but they're forecasting between 95 and 100. So we love it. Well, we made a little wrong turn there. Back on the road we just were up with the bike, so we thought we had better turn around, which we did, to the expert driving of Lawrence. And so we're headed back to 244, which gets us hopefully where we want to go. You have to put up with this stuff. Oh, I mean, it's just a continuous stream. And it's amazing how many I missed before I got the camera on.
Die for a home like that?
Yeah, it really is nice. Yeah.
Oh, that guy.
What town is this?
This is Hill.
This is Hill. Hill City. What? And we don't know where we can go.
Because we gotta get down, Dave.
The road is. Well, we had to make a little detour here. And we're hoping we can get across the road. Amaze me. We'll be cutting most of this out, but using what's good. Oh, geez. We made it to Deadwood. Like, there might be something going on. Looks like there's some bikers in town.
You know this way.
We're looking for the Franklin Hotel.
Seems to be out of town.
Yeah, it must be a convention. Hotel, we've just made a turn, and it's up there on the right with the far one with the flags, not this one.
This may be a real challenge for us.
We've made it to the Deadwood Hotel.
We've got a cut. Oh, we found it behind the hotel, which is right there. Chip and Harry, we've joined them, and they didn't know how obnoxious I was going to be with this camera.
This is a documentary, so that
yes,
whenever
it
you're
going
to find them, you can...
This is Chip right here.
Got this, got that.
All right. Well, it is Sunday. We all wanted to go to church, but Larry wants to go to the wet t-shirt.
I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Aerial.
night, I guess.
Yeah, we've got blackjack here, blackjack over
in
the
Star West. He's trying to find my gambling. Chip and I have some really high standards.
Too fucking late.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm the hostess.
Okay.
Yeah, the hostess, but your waitress will be right over. Okay.
Thanks, Erica.
Actually,
that'll
be a waiter.
Good job.
I just called him a girl.
Who's our waitress?
Right there.
What are you trying to do?
I'm trying to peddle liquor here.
Okay.
And what is your name?
Melissa.
Melissa.
Yep.
Harry. Yeah. Game. Glad to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
The stories begin.
I've read about it. He said, well, I had a typing question. And he said, you know, you can help. You can fix that. He said, type in personality, you have high blood pressure.
Anybody in here?
Yes, I mean, it's a little
hard. What? Oh, yeah.
All right, now hold it.
Oh, there's Larry right there.
I can see.
Yeah. Oh, Larry.
Can you imagine? Here with this bike right here.
We're going to buy that for Ray Lee, and she's kicking ass with that bike.
Okay.
One beautiful and naked.
I like it.
God damn, I got to take my clothes off.
Similar weather. Women up there with big tits, they're just everywhere. Come in here, my guys, I want to, we're filming right now.
Oh, we're, this is part
oh
of
yeah, the being part of the crew, he's now giving direction.
He's a director.
Yeah. No, assistant
no.
Maybe.
No.
Alright, what are we
I was
doing?
Errand boy.
This is the best thing I've had in my mouth on this trip.
Well,
there's a hell of a lot of opportunity.
God, though. Here I am, sorry.
All right. Yeah, I better head up on the cutting room floor. Thank you very much.
There are a lot of bikes out here that they're willing to have to get wet.
Well, they're all kind of giving the bike an eye. I do too.
Oh, Morgan.
So he moves, he brings a motion before Rayleigh. She inherited the case. You'll like this. And he files this goddamn motion for reconsideration for the sentencing. And there's clear law, you can't fuck with that. Contacts Mike Wallace. You heard the story. Mike Wallace then, and Rayleigh's enough of a friend of everybody that she, people play jokes on him. So her.
If I don't see a blonde woman, I'm jumping.
She's not turning around.
It's not working, Harry.
Oh.
that old fart next to her, he's protected.
All right, this picture is dedicated to Harry, Larry, and Chip.
I don't put any lead on this brother. I just have pants.
Can't take any more. They're going back.
Right, tired, beat up,
whipped. Tired old souls, all back.
Tired old souls. All the old farts are going back to sleep.
Going to check on the bikes before breakfast.
7:30.
Harry's getting ready. Back again.
Uh-huh.
When they were there, Coach K came in, and then Calvin Hill.
Oh yeah.
It was just a nice crowd, you know? And it was funny because he didn't have.
This is the leader of the pack here.
Welcome to Spearfish Canyon Road.
Spearfish Canyon Road, all right.
Sex life in my first marriage, Bud, was really great. I particularly liked the one in the spring. But I knew I was in trouble when she started to scream her own name during orgasms.
Yeah, I'm going to have two copies of Arrive at Sturgis.
Nice bike.
Yeah, it is.
Man.
Pretty.
I thought mine was in my bag on the bike.
Help me.
Well, Larry might buy a new trailer. Cash is leaving us.
It really doesn't make much difference.
I don't, is that what it says? Is that what it is?
Oh.
One-eyed Jacks.
We can get lunch sitting up here, can't we? Can we get a burger thing in bar? Can I get a picture of you with these three retro rates?
Yes, you can. Yep, I do.
Come here.
I did too.
Well,
I'll show you.
Better get on down.
Right over there. Right by Pee Wee's Hardtail Customs.
Lots of stuff in there now.
ride.
Take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise.
We're at the Harley dealership, right?
Yeah, Black Hills Harley dealership.
Mine was over 100.
Over 100, eh?
Yeah, bud.
You want anything? You want water?
Yeah.
All right, we're going to go on into the air-conditioned area here. Oh, that's fine. Larry's looking. Unfortunately, you didn't get to see the ride. You missed all the good parts, but that's what all I can do.
What did I miss?
Okay, Carol, I just got done talking to you on the phone, and you couldn't hear the bikes go by.
It's starting to move. Oh, yeah, we got to get that one, buddy.
Okay, oh boy, we're starting to go to dinner or something, probably just more of a look-see than anything, I guess.
You gotta focus.
Now do it. Yeah.
Well, he has to run 110 octane gasoline.
So he's burning aviation.
I think no, he's got something on sand. All these universities are going to sue the equipment any good. Why are we asking to do this? 7:30.
Edwards Ocean Club above, something's blowing over here.
Checks and I want the bottle of wine on my chest. Okay. It's going to be a Frog's Leap, Sauvignon Blanc, and then we'll go from there.
Okay. Next to your wine, so I need to get a bin number.
Oh, okay. I'll give you a bin number on it in 2 seconds.
There you go, boss.
Boss again.
Oops, I'm sorry. Second day of fun.
Hard riding.
Yeah, pretty good hard riding. 100 and some odd degrees yesterday.
80 today?
They were saying mid 80s, yeah. So that'd be nice. Everybody's checking in.
Well, okay. If I don't get a hold of you, tell me happy birthday for me. I'm in.
And not to be left out, the third number checks in.
We're always getting the backs of these guys. Breakfast it is.
Hi, girls. They're all here right now. Live. I brought them in special.
After 3 miles of walking, we finally found a place.
I think, because that's really the whole...
Down and
one local newspaper up there, they had, they printed her stats after every game, every weekend.
Well, we just had breakfast. They seem to want to take the long way around. You're fine. We just stopped. They knew they got cold wearing those t-shirts. Yep, he's changed for the fourth time today. Great riding. I'm sorry you don't have any pictures of the riding. So, what do you think?
I've never had such a good time with jackasses in my life.
There you go.
Don't really take my picture when he says jackass.
Well, wait a minute. When this film's done, I want to know where you got that hat, because I sure don't. I don't want to go there. All right.
Hey, I have some class. It's a class hat.
Now, what'd you say?
I said that's a class hat.
We just parked. Yeah, you see all kinds here. Bikes away for the night for the Wyoming trip in the morning.
I can't remember that.
here he got his bike washed. Looks great. For the ride tomorrow.
Wait until I get older. I'm gonna have my own.
Roughly 6 o'clock, and we're all getting ready to depart the White Castle down there. Got our bikes out of the parking lot. And looking for a good day. Now there's a man who knows what he's doing right there.
We're doing on time, Blair. 6:12.
There he's down in the parking lot getting his bike out.
Intersection, we're going to turn left.
What are we doing?
I have to go.
All right, we're at, I don't know how, about 130 miles out. And had to stop for gas.
Sorry.
It was an emergency. We were almost out. And that's where we're stopping for breakfast in Buffalo.
67 miles, and I looked at my gas gauge and I said, I wonder if I'm going to make it, you know. I did have, I was a good fraction above. I think I probably could have made it to Buffalo.
Breakfast is over. I don't know if the bikes can take the extra weight. Okay, a little roadside stop here. Been riding through beautiful country. Hard to get it all in. And down there are the boys. Two of them. And there you go. Some guys are taking pictures. Some guys are tired. And some guys are way up here. No, don't move.
Don't move. You don't want my backside.
Yeah, get that big eagle.
Oh yeah, you want to get my best side, is that it? All right. I'm going to make Yellowstone today.
Quit taking pictures, eh?
Boys are headed out.
Yeah, okay. I remembered that from my last trip. It's just gorgeous. Well, I honestly don't know, but I remember those beautiful cliffs and red rock. Just another stop to dress down. Now it's 80 degrees. Well, 300 and some odd miles later, we're stopping in Cody and got gas again.
65.7.
All right, that answers that question. Here we are in Cody. Well, we're going to put a little rain gear on, looks like, because it's going to be coming in. Well, we just went through the entrance and a little road work here in Yellowstone. Yes, for sure.
I wanted to get a look at this road job. It's gnarly. It's a tough job. I mean, it's like high, narrow.
All right, we've met another Spartan out here.
Other places.
Lives in Cody. 25 minutes to wait here, so he took to drinking.
Heavy stuff, too.
Harry just left, and we're trying to decide what to do in before we go to the hotel, the lodge. Oh no, you can. I can put them together.
Okay, well, I only got it half.
Boy,
where the crime occurred.
Right.
Nobody
lives in, piece, huh?
In that piece of the park in Montana.
Well, the guys are taking pictures of this hole. Let's take a look down in there. Larry's getting the shot.
You don't believe that?
Headed back to the bikes. Well, what is it, Thursday morning? Chip and Harry have gone. We're about to pack up our bikes, go in and get breakfast, and head on out around the park, and then we think on a rather long journey up into Montana.
Well, we had a surprise visitor this morning. Couldn't quite make it. He had to sleep in.
Bon voyage.
Well, tell Stacy I said hi.
I will.
We really should make an afternoon.
We're on our way to Old Faithful, so just another tidbit of information. And it was, well, we're getting gas at Old Faithful, and we're both complaining about being frigid. It's so cold. We're going to see Old Faithful. He's rushing over to get a seat for the Old Faithful blowout. There's the old lodge coming up here. He's mapping our way out. 15 minutes, okay. Or somewhere thereabouts. Going to make a call and take the maps back.
Okay.
They didn't do that the last time. Well, old Faithful didn't go off. But
next to the neighbor did.
There she goes. Fine.
The
sun is a great angle. It's pretty against that sky.
It's gorgeous.
That's the sun in the right spot in early. Yeah, that's pretty much it. All right, Old Faithful's over. We're going where? To Madison?
Madison, Yellowstone Park.
All right. Sorry for the bouncing. Three calves looking for their mom.
We're making it tough for anybody to come into the park from the east, period.
Yeah. We're in Montana now, a short stint in Montana, and then back down into Wyoming and on to Cody. Been out of the park. You missed all the riding, and that goes for all the days we were here.
Here we are at the subway in Cody, and we're going to try to make Sheridan or something tonight, because we got a ways to go to get back to Deadwood. That's where we came from, and that's what's blowing this way. We hope we don't get any more rain.
Okay, we just arrived in Sheridan, and I think we lucked out. We got two rooms. We got a 2890 room for 8290 or something. So there you go.
Off the Highland.
Wearing your hat too. Dine at Pizza Hut tonight. Just a short walk over there.
We made it here. This is our dining. This is my dining partner.
That's right.
And
we're having gourmet pizza.
Yep, so, just let you know.
The space shuttle landed correctly, and now the Sturgis shuttle is preparing for landing. It's Friday morning, about 5:30, and we're getting ready to go. We ride today, wet and all.
Just look at it from the distance.
All right, she's about... I don't know, 2 minutes to six. We're on schedule.
Ready to go.
Well, we just made it back to Deadwood. And we're gonna go in the shop, and then we're on our way. Once we load the bike. Well, we're gonna go over to the trailer and load our bikes. All right, we're gonna load the bikes. We're on our way.
That's fine.
I'd just soon get the hell out of Dodge before we start thinking about that.
Okay, yeah, I agree.
Okay, we're on the road at 10:23 local time. That'd be 12:23 at home, and we're getting ready to get out of here.
Hopefully we'll be home sometime tomorrow.
Well, we're just outside of Sioux Falls and they're light. It's not 250, it's 262 for regular. Been nothing but a stream of traffic since we left. Unbelievable.
It's 6 o'clock local time, 7 o'clock Michigan time, I guess.
And we're in Forest City or something in Wisconsin. And we're headed out, should be home in 12 hours or so. Well, we've been lucky enough to get into the gas market just as it price is raised considerably, and every 45 minutes another $55. And there's the guy doing it.
Right.
He has no heart. He just keeps putting it in there. Okay, we stopped at Hardee's, as you can see, and Larry's getting it's gonna kill him.
We heard about these buns for at least 5 days.
Yeah, some guy over there in South Dakota told me about them. All right.
So we're gonna give these things a try because apparently.
I'm sorry. Oh, it's too much sugar. All right, we're in Ashland, Wisconsin, filling up again. Gas prices are skyrocketing as we go. Well, we've been on the road 7 hours, 3 tanks of gas, and we just stopped here in Christmas.
All right, are we good to go?
We're good to go. Let's go.
Well, we're coming up on the bridge shortly. Larry has done it again. Taking us to our pre-final destination.
We're so happy to be here.
Hi.
Just to show we were here, this is the end.
Well, I might go get me a new tattoo. I'll take my old Harley for a 3-day cruise. Might even grow me a Fu Manchu. And it's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's some hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good? It's a great day to be alive. I know the sun's still shining when I close my eyes. There's some hard times in the neighborhood, but why can't every day be just this good?
Story that you won't believe, but I fell in love last Friday evening with the girl I saw on a ballroom TV screen. Well, I was just getting ready to get my hat when she caught my eye, and I put it back, and I ordered myself a couple of more shots and beers. The night that I fell in love with a roller derby queen, around and round, all round and round, the meanest uncle woman that anybody ever seen. Down in the arena, she was 5'6", 215, a bleach blonde bomber with a streak of mean. She knew how to knuckle and she knew how to scuffle.